house was on fire. First service. So let's see what's happening in the second service. I see a few bases here from the first service. Stay over for the second service. So I decided to stay tuned. To hear what he is going to say here, a little different from the first. Remember that the theme for the year, annual recognition this day, is stand up and stand out. Following the previous speakers, we're leaving the last of the month, I'm bringing you some very specific steps in how to do exactly that. Stand up and stand out. I'm bringing to you three steps, and they make up what we use as prayer. But they are the composition steps of prayer, which means that prayer is a composite of three main ideas, central points. The first being vision, and we're going to talk about vision. And the second is imagination, and the third is visualization. Vision, imagination, visualization. Will you repeat? Vision, imagination, visualization. Think about it. Think about vision now. Remember, you're praying. And you're praying with these three ideas in mind, these three principles. We call the rules in prayer. And they're working concentric, right? All together, synergetically, teacher. Am I right? So you have received a vision. In that vision, extending out from it, you have to activate this office of God in your mind. That's called imagination. You have in you the office of imagination. Extend it out from that into your world. Visualization, all working together. You got that, don't you? That's a nice little picture. Now we're going to develop this concept through a topic today, and my topic is feeling is the secret. Can you say that with me? Feeling is the secret. That's the secret to answer prayer, demonstrating prayer. It's all in the feeling. Let's say it again. Feeling is the secret. Let us come. Let's say it one more time. Feeling is the secret in prayer. All right. I'm going to bring this to life through the letter that has been left for you in your operations manual. That's called the Holy Bible. And it's in Genesis chapter 27. The story is about Isaac and his wife Rebekah, the mother of two sons, Jacob and Esau. And it's talking about how it is, what is that the elder son, by tradition, receives the father's blessing. But in this case, the younger son, that was Esau, the elder son, this case is the younger son, Jacob, through the manipulation and scheming and deceitfulness of his mom, stole his blessing. So we're talking about the stolen blessing. We're talking about deception. We're talking about man's way of looking at this and how to move your way of thinking to understand what God is doing in this situation. What we're doing here is learning how to do what Ernest Holmes makes so explicitly clear in the book that he wrote called The Creative Process in the Individual. That's what we're talking about. The creative process in the individual. As I read this story, you have it in the program, and you're going to kind of look, read along with me in just a minute. But you're seeing this story as a psychological drama in your own mind. That's what these stories are about in the Bible. We don't argue by it. We don't say it doesn't mean this, it doesn't say that. Whatever it means to say it to you, how can I argue and say what it says to you, what it means to you? But in the context of teaching here, we're using one system that's called a metaphysical understanding of the Bible. Meta is not an occult word. Metaphysical. Meta means what? Beyond. The physical, the limit. What is God saying here from a spiritual, deeper spiritual understanding? The story itself is an Oriental illustration. It's an Eastern presentation of a story, literal in its presentation, but with a deeper meaning, a spiritual meaning, relating to how your mind works, the conscious and the subconscious aspects of the one mind, the male and the female aspects of the one mind. So don't come and ask me questions about why did you steal from the mama and the hip? Hey, there's no answers to those questions. You got to go down the street to the other places and ask those questions. Here, you got to ask the right question to get the right answer. What does this mean to me as it applies to my daily life now? To this sickness that I'm experiencing, I can answer that. To this impasse that I'm dealing with in the relationship now, I can answer it from that context. From a spiritual context, I can, you know, I can relate. But don't, if you're still coming literal, and I tell you it's metaphysical, I can't help it. I didn't go to that school. Job chapter 23 says, in a dream, in a vision of the night, when deep sleep falleth upon men in slumberings of other day, then he opens the ears of men and seals their instruction. That's what you want to hear in this story and read in this story about Jacob and Esau, Isaac and Rebekah. You see, Jacob had received a vision. A vision, imagination, and visualization. Vision is the voice of God. It is the eye of God seeing through you, and you see what God is seeing through you. You have a vision. Vision speaks in a dream. Isn't that what it said? In vision, in mental images, a vision. And it shows up as a statement of fact in and through your need. In the form of answered prayer. Vision is an announcement that I am well out of sickness. I got my stuff now out of the need. Whatever the problem is, it comes with the answer. When the problem shows up, the answer is in it. No matter what it is, no matter what level it is expressing in your life, whatever it is that you need, it is already done. You pray from the finish line. You pray from the end. You pray from knowing that it's already done. And you run to the answer that already is. That's what this story is about. The Living Bible says this about it in Habakkuk 2. But these things I plan won't always happen right away, but slowly, steadily, surely, the time approaches when the vision will be fulfilled. Your need, your answer, it will be fulfilled. If it seems slow, do not despair. King James Version say, wait for it. Do not despair. For these things will surely come to pass. Just be patient. Metaphysical translation of that is chill out. They will not be overdue a single day. But there is something that you have to do. And that is called in the meantime. See, in the meantime, you gotta know what to do. Now, there is a term here that I have to give you the metaphysical definition and understanding of. And this term and these two words are the most misunderstood term, two words, that is in the English lexicon, in the dictionary, but you'll find it in the scripture. And those words are shut up. Death and life are in the power of the tongue.
Yes.
And everything right there is what we have to control. I'm sure it shows up. But then you have to understand the meaning of deja vu. Deja vu, the dictionary says, is literally, it means literally. Literally, it means that we're going to deal with it from the scripture. But Jacob in this story, you're going to see, is living through a deja vu. But you don't, it means nothing if you can't see it happening in your life. See that same thing is happening in your life, a deja vu. The deja vu, the prayer that's already been answered, you're living through the answer, it's unfolding, it's evolving, it's repeating itself, and you're going to walk into it again. It's happening again. The answer's already happened. The deja vu is experiencing something again that has already happened in the past. Deja vu is the phenomenon of having the strong sensation that an event or experience currently being experienced has already been experienced in the past. Strong sensation means feeling. A strong feeling, so let's say feeling is a secret. Feeling is the secret, okay? Deja vu is a feeling of familiarity, and deja vu, he's already lived through something, is a feeling of recollection. So today, what you're going to experience, what you're experiencing right now, let's think about a sickness that you might be experiencing, or somebody that you're praying with or about who might be. Let's think about a financial need, a housing need, a transportation need, a problem in a relationship, and then you fill in the blank. You've got to start from the end, that it's already done, it's already finished. And then you're sleeping through it right now. All right? And you're remembering, and you're awakening to the reality that you've already done. The girl said in the song, deja vu, I keep remembering. I keep remembering. I keep remembering. Remembering me, remembering you. We got to keep remembering what God said he would do. He's already, he'll do. What God said has been done, it has been done. Remember the promise.
Yes. Yes.
But what helps you to remember is your feeling. Feeling is the secret. Okay, now it came to pass. It came about when Isaac was old and his eyes were too dim to see. And he called his older son Esau and said to him, my son. And he said to him, here I am. Now, Isaac is the father. Rebekah is the mother. We're talking about the male and female aspects of the mind. Therefore, the conscious and the subconscious aspects of the mind. We're talking about the communication between them. We're two or more. We're two agree. We're two agree. He's touching anything. There I am in the midst of him. All right? There's some communication going on in your soul right now. Subconscious imagery whispering to the conscious mind. Now, Esau, the eldest, representing physics of nature, more animalistic, dealing with things as they are, and Jacob representing more of the mental aspect inside of nature. All this is dialogue going on in your life, on the other side of your thinking. And she said, Isaac said, behold now, he's talking to Esau, I am old and I do not know the day of my death now then. Please take your gear, your quiver, and your bow, and go out to the field and hunt game for me, and prepare a savory dish for me, such as I love, and bring it to me that I may eat, so that my soul may bless you before I die. Now the conscious mind, Isaac, has a way of looking at things and seeing things and has his plan, right?
Yes.
And he's telling him, his son about it. But the next verse 5 says, but my mother's missing. The mother, that subconscious is missing. Rebecca was missing while Isaac spoke to his son Esau. So when Esau went to the field to hunt for game to bring home, then Rebecca said to her son, say, come down, Jacob. Behold, I heard your father speaking something you don't know. You know how mothers are. Behold, I heard your father speak to your brother Esau, saying, bring me some game and prepare a savory dish for me that I may eat and bless you in the presence of the Lord before my death. Well, let's talk more about Rebecca. For you, I got this from the Metaphysical Bible Dictionary. It's going to be share one paragraph here about Rebecca. And just for your information, just Google the Unity Bible. It will pop up for you, and you're given the whole Metaphysical Bible Dictionary there. But you have to sit on the information.
I got it.
You pay me. This is what it says about Rebecca. Rebecca is the mother conceived, in which these states of mind were gestated and are still growing. Desires the mental to take precedence of the animal. See, that's subjective.
Huge.
So she suggests through her inner imagery to the dominant consciousness, Isaac, that his blessings shall fall upon Jacob. This seems a trick upon the blind holy father. He says seems, right? But it is an oriental illustration of how we are moved by subjective states of consciousness. And in our half-blind understanding, except the fact is that the soul is constantly suggesting to us in dreams, visions, and mental flashes. These suggestions are not always to be followed. They may be for our eyes good, and they may not. The spiritual understanding must determine this. Got it?
Yeah.
So you will know. You will know. But one thing that we're learning is the scripture says, trust in the Lord. That's how you know. With all your heart. And lean not unto your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. So you don't have to deal with that question. If you're following this, he will lead. He will guide you, and you will know. Now, let's go on, and then verse 8 says, now, remember Rebecca now. That's that subconscious mind. That's that feminine side, female side of the mind. You know, and it says to the conscious mind, and he's talking through the conscious mind, talking to Jacob. We're going to tell children's direction. So you have that discretionary power, you know. And she says, now, therefore, my son, listen to me. As I command you. So she says, go now to the flock and bring me 2 choice young goats from there, that I may prepare them as a savory dish for your father, such as he loves. Then you shall bring it to your father, that he may eat, so that he may bless you before his death. Now you going one way and then there's change. But a lot of times we've been going that way, and God is telling us that we resist. And we resist because we don't know how to listen to God, because a lot of other thoughts come through our mind about the thing that He's sending us direction. Yeah. Watch this. Jacob answered his mother. That's that. Okay, listen to what Jacob is saying to his mother Rebecca. Behold, Esau, my brother, is a hairy man, and I am a smooth man. Perhaps my father will feel me, then I will be as a deceiver in his sight, and I will bring upon myself a curse and not a blessing. But his mother said to him, shut up. Yes, she said. We got to do some thought work. You know, this house is yours. Now, you don't have good credit, right? You don't have the right amount of money because they got standards and rules and norms. You understand what I'm saying? Somebody, you've been charged with this, and either you're innocent or you're guilty, and there's no contest kind of thing. I remember I was down in Long Beach, because that's where I lived, and I was at the beach one morning, and I went there to meet. And when I backed my car into the parking thing here, I'm sitting there comfortably reading, and then the cop comes out and gives me a ticket. Because you backed into the parking thing instead of driving. Are you serious? A ticket. So I said, I'm not getting this ticket, but I was guilty. So I went to court. And you know, they take out their minds. And when I come up, he reads the chart. Da, 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 da. He said, how do you plead? Because they prepare you to just keep wasting time how to plead. I said, well, he said, how do you plead? How do you plead? Guilty? I said, no contest. He said, well, did you park in there with him? I said, yes, I did. Okay, it's this. So the point is the conscience, how do you feel when you walk in there? Do you feel guilty? Yes, you did it, but do you feel guilty?
Yeah.
But I'm feeling good. And moved into this house several years going forward. You know how you get accustomed to adapt this stuff. You adapt to stress. You adapt to pressure, whatever. Well, I had adapted to the payment plan that I had. I was making it. But then I started hearing, because I bought it at China and stuff was up there, you know, I'd be crazy. And then I started hearing people talk about, I got a home loan by the Haitian. And they were just agreeing, and I'm saying, well, how did I get that? So I went out there thinking, I'm going to get a home loan by the Haitian too, based on the report that they should be working from, the information that I gave them. I was dealing with Chase. Chase was the model. Well, Chase and Wells Fargo, at that time, were the ones who were not incorporating the plan in the government that they wanted at that time. And so I was denied. And so, but I was managing my financial situation okay, but I would have been much more confident if the thing had been, So what happened, I had a second time, and it was denied. But you see, it's how you go in your feeling that's going to determine the outcome. So I started listening to Rebecca. I started listening to the mother principle. I laid low and waited for instructions and directions. And somehow when I went there the third time, you don't give up. I learned something on that third visit because this time the right person had been set before me, as opposed to the others. She says, well, I'm looking here and I see that you have never missed a payment. Your credit score is good. You have no late certificate or whatever. Yeah, I know that. But this time I decided to listen. And then she gave me a sort of a wink. I got to get into the feeling. Yeah. I went back and changed my feeling. See, my profile at that time is I'm all right. Now I can handle it. Then my feeling changed to trouble. Sometimes it's okay to be a little trouble. You understand? So when the payment came due the next time, I got it. The next time, I ain't got a letter. Third time, they say, you know, is there anything we can do to help you? I said, no, you can't. Yes, I want you to. Then the other bill collectors were calling and saying, is there anything that we can do to help you? When do you think you can? I said, your guess is good as mine. So every time, just before that third payment is due, you know, we find a way to borrow some money. I said, so that's what I'm telling them. When they call it, I say, yeah, maybe I can borrow some money from a friend or something. You know, I'll get it in there. So I got it in there. You know, keep the thing. So when I went down there that third time, my profile had changed. Sometimes you got to change your profile to match your present. Feeling is the secret. So I went down there the next time in a different feeling of lack. That was not my reality. It was just a fact, temporary fact. Now I have to learn some skills. Listen to your mama, the mother principle. So the mother principle is guiding me. And so when I went down the third time, I had the right profile, matching the right feeling that I temporarily put myself in, and it was approved. And so your house is half the amount of what used to be in downtown, 1%. Isn't that something? Feeling is the secret that you listen. Listen to Rebecca, and Rebecca knows something that Isaac does not know. Lean not unto thy own understanding, but in all thy ways acknowledge him, and he will direct your paths. So, that was imagination. The first part was vision. This is endless imagination. So he went and got them and brought them to his mother, and his mother made savory food such as his father loved. Then Rebecca took her the best garments. Then Rebecca took the best garments of Esau, her son, which were with her in the house, and put them on Jacob, her younger son. And she put the skins of the goats on his hands and on the smooth part of his neck. imagination. She's working in his imagination. He's getting him into the feeling of already being Esau, so that he can go before his father as he has become. You don't go to your father, which is God, sick. You don't go to your father with problems. You don't go to your father with stuff. You don't go to your father angry. You don't go to your father broke, busted, and disgusted. You don't go to your father fired, angry, disappointed, all that stuff. Fill in the blank. You go to your father as you see yourself. And your father puts it into one. Are you listening? Feeling is the secret. If you are sick, you say, I am well. And you dress like you are well. You smell like you are well. You walk like you are well. You talk like you are well. You now as you are now. Live in that house right now. Drive that car right now. See yourself performing the service in your talent and getting paid perfect pay in every way. See yourself doing it now. Act as though you can do the things that you couldn't do before now. And then the Father approves it and says, yes, I am. Then Rebecca took the garments and put them on. Okay, she also gave the savory food and the bread which she had made to her son Jacob. Then he came to his father and said, my father, and he said, here I am. Who are you, my son? Jacob said to his father, I am Esau, your firstborn. So he had become the thing. Then he went to his father. I have done as you told me. Get up, please, sit and eat of my game, that you may be blessed, that you may bless me. And Isaac said to his son, how is it that you have done this so quickly, son? And he said, because the Lord your God called me out. I decided to shut up and follow God's instructions. Go where God told me to go, do what God told me to do, and now I'm showing up as the thing itself. Then Isaac said to Jacob, please come close, that I may feel you, my son. See the feeling? God wants to feel how you feel. God wants to be convinced. You got to convince the subconscious mind that I am the thing. Scripture puts it this way. It is done unto you as you believe. If you believe yourself without it and see yourself without it, you're without it. If you see yourself can't do it, you can't do it. Feeling is the secret. So Jacob came close to his father. You got to come close to the father. And he left and he felt him and said, the voice is the voice of Jacob, but the hands are the hands of Esau. All right? His hands were not smooth anymore. His hands were not smooth anymore, hear me. His hands were now hairy, becoming the thing. See, he didn't worry anymore. He wasn't sick anymore. He didn't have a feeling of impossibility anymore. He didn't have a feeling of being burdened anymore. He didn't have a feeling of being afraid to show up to claim his stuff anymore. You want to keep on going? Come on. You keep thinking. And think about yourself. I'm just trying to give you some clues and some clues of what you might be thinking, what might be an impasse for you, what might be blocking your healing, your expression of getting your stuff. I can't name everything. Smooth hand. You got smooth hands? You got smooth hands in some area. You got to grow some hair. You know, you got to get something. This is the visualization part. You got to see yourself, you know, with hairy hands. Having become the thing without the problem. He did not recognize him because his hands were hairy, the scripture says. Isaac didn't recognize him now. Didn't recognize him because his hands were hairy, like his brother Esau's hands. So he blessed him. He didn't recognize him with and as his face. You gotta forget, just stop recognizing yourself as you were. Stop recognizing yourself as in the past. Start seeing yourself in the way that you really want to be or become. That means that the subconscious mind has convinced the conscious mind of its new reality. Matthew 18 says, again I say to you, if two of you agree on earth about anything they ask, it will be done for them by my Father on heaven. That's what I just preached to you. Mm-hmm. Then everybody get that. So then they repeat this. And that's the teaching of this scripture, everything that I've just demonstrated through an illustration. Read it again. The two are the conscious mind and the subconscious mind, the head and the heart, sense to soul, thinking to feeling. Got to agree. When you bring him into agreement, he says, there I am in the midst of them, that's the Christ, that's the answer. Let me read it again. Again, I say it to you so many times, but I'm saying it again. If two of you agree on earth, in your life, in your world, about anything they ask, it will be done for them by my Father in heaven. So he said, bring it to me, and I will eat of my son's game, that I may bless you. And he brought it to them, and he ate it. He also brought him wine and drink. Then his father Isaac said to him, please come closer and kiss me, my son. In other words, convince me. Convince me. Are you convincing your father, that's God, that you do believe is done unto you as you believe? Is your attitude an attitude of convincing of you to say something? So he came close and kissed him, and when he smelled the smell of his garments, he blessed him and said, see, the smell of my son is like the smell of you, which the Lord has blessed. Now, may God give you the dew of heaven, this is the blessing, and of the fatness of the earth, and the abundance of rain and new wine, and people will serve you, and nations bow down to you. Be master of your brothers, and may your mother's sons bow down to you. Cursed be those who curse you, and blessed be those who bless you. How do you smell? Do you smell like sickness? My mother passed away when she was 94, yes. But, hey, she was getting up every morning before eating her breakfast and clean up. She had to have her face done. She had to have her lipstick on. Everything else had to be done. She had to all of that. And then, what's your mother say? Do you hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
Now, ready. But she was in the feeling of living and not dying. That just had to take it. But she was living. Do you see? How did you feel? She woke up feeling alive, not dead. And the clothes that she wore were not for the mortuary. I'm over that one. You know what I'm saying? I'm living, I'm alive. How do you feel is how it's going to turn out. And so it is.
So it is.